Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Minecraft video, I'll be showing you how to change the default sounds inside of the game. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and also share. You can support my channel through Patreon, and don't forget to subscribe. I do lots of videos every week on different graphics programs and also on Minecraft. There's my current schedule right there. Okay, let's get to it. Changing the sounds in Minecraft is actually very easy to do, but you'll need a few things. You'll need some kind of a sound editing program, and I'll show you one that I use in just a second. You'll also need to know how to set up a basic resource pack or texture pack. Here's my folder for doing this, which has my assets folder, and then my pack.mc meta file, and my pack.png icon file. If you don't know how to get to this stage right here, then take a look at my previous video on how to create custom texture packs and resource packs, and it's all explained over in there. Okay, once we're at this point, one thing you'll need to do is to go into your assets folder right here and into the Minecraft folder, and we'll need a new folder in here. So let's make a new folder, and it's going to be called sounds. There we are. We'll be using that new sounds folder. Okay, that's all set and ready to go. Now, we need to get back over into Minecraft. Let's go over here to Minecraft. And I'm just at this game menu page. Click on Options and click on Resource Packs. And then down here, click on Open Resource Pack Folder. This takes you right into the location for the resource packs for the game. And then just back up one level until you're at the Minecraft level. Once you're here, you want to find the folder named Assets right there. Open that one up and look for Indexes. Open that up, and in here you'll see several JSON files. The one you want is the one that matches the version of Minecraft you're running. It should be the last one. Right now I'm running 1.14. Let's go ahead and open this up by double clicking on it. There we are. Now I'm viewing this in Windows Notepad. Any text viewer will work. We're not going to be doing anything to this file. This is just for reference, so it doesn't matter what you open this up with. Now we need to find something in here. We're going to be changing the sound that a cow makes when you hit him. So let's search for cow. Edit, come down to Find Next, and then just type in cow, and then Find Next. There we go. You see there's a cow right down there. I'm just click on Find Next until I get down to the one I'm looking for. And there it is. Just cancel that out. And we have three of these. Hurt 1, Hurt 2, and Hurt 3. You can put in different sounds in here. See, there's our Hurt 1 right there. There's the Hurt 2, and there's the Hurt 3. They'll play randomly, so you get a little different sound each time. What we want, though, is this whole line right there. You want to memorize that line. I'm just going to right-click Copy. So we have that, and then I'll open up another copy of Notepad. Actually, I'll just do it this way. File, New. There we go. Right-click and Paste. Now, since there are three of these, let's just duplicate that and then change these numbers here. Now, that's number 2 and number 3. We'll use the same file, the same sound file on all three, but this just gives me the names that we need to have. So there we go. Okay, that's all we need with that JSON file. Again, we're just using that just for information. Go ahead and close that out. There's what we need to know. Now the first part of here, this is the path that we need to have. We've already made the sounds folder. We need to make another folder for mob, and then inside that one, a folder for cows. Go ahead and get that set up. There's our sounds. Let me just pull it down so you can see that. There we go. Open the sounds up. Let's make a new folder in here for mob. A new folder inside of that one. Open that one up. New folder for cow. Open that one up. And here's where we'll place our new sound files. Okay, so that part of this is all taken care of. We have our path all set up, and we know the names that we need for our sound file. Okay, let's now bring up a program to edit our sounds. And the one I like to use is Audacity because it's free and it works very well. It's a very powerful program. You can find it easily online just by doing a search for Audacity, but I'll go ahead and put a link on my Minecraft page for that as well. Okay, let me bring that up. And there it is. Something else I want to point out, let's go back over here for our sound files, and these are in the OGG format, O-G-G format. You'll mostly find sounds in the MP3 or WAV format, and Audacity can save out to the OGG format, so that makes it a good choice for that as well. Let's go ahead and open one up. I've already saved out a lot of sounds. I'll go here to open, and down here I have a cow wave right there. This is a standard wave file. I'll open that one up. There it is. I'm not sure if the microphone will pick this up or not, but I'll go ahead and play this. There we go. A little nicer sound than the minimal sound that they use inside of Minecraft. I don't care about this beginning stuff, so I'm going to just select that, hit the delete key, and get rid of that. Just have the larger moo in here. Let's now save this out. File, export to the OGG format right here. And it saves it back into the same location. I already have one up here that's called cow new. Let me just make this one cow new 2. There we go. And choose save. If you want, you can add in more information. We don't need that, so I'll just choose OK. And that's it. That's all we need to do to make our sound file. And again, the link for Audacity is on my Minecraft page. Just get rid of that. There we go. Okay, so we now have our folder right here. And we have our sound file. Let me bring up the folder that I saved that into. We can then bring that file over into here. There we go. There's our file with the sounds. And there's one that we just made right here, cow new 2. I'm going to right drag this over here and choose copy. Now we have that in place, but as you recall, it has to be named this HURT1, HURT2, and HURT3. So let's just rename this. I'll call this one HURT1. Let's drag a new copy in. There we go. And let's make this one HURT2. And drag another new copy in. And this one is HURT3. Okay, and I can get rid of that. So there we go. We now have our three files in the right format, and they're inside of the right folder location, as we can see right up here. Double check that. So it's assets, Minecraft, sounds, mob, cow, and there's the files. Okay, that's all done. Let's go back here to our basic folder. I have mine in my Mars resource pack location. So you've changed these sounds or added in new sounds actually in here. Now the way that Minecraft works is it looks inside of the sounds folder if there is one, and it looks for any sounds in that and then uses these instead of the sounds that come with the game by default. We now need to zip this stuff together, so I'll hold down the control key here, choose all three, right click, and I use 7-zip to add these to an archive. There it is. I'm just going to call this one Sounds2. There we go. This, of course, is the same steps that I show how to do in my how to make a custom Minecraft texture pack or resource pack. And I use the 7-zip program over there as well. It's a very easy to use and powerful program for compressing things into archives like zip archives, and it works great with Minecraft. Okay, I'll let this go ahead and finish, and I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. Now all the steps from this point forward are really the same as making any new texture pack. So there's our new sound zip right there. Let's come down and open the resource folder. Here's my resource folder right there. I'm going to right drag this over here and copy. There it is. Sounds2. Just get those out of the way. Choose done and done. Then go back into options again. Back into resource packs again. And there's that new file. I'll just hit the arrow here to move it over here. It should come to the top of the pack just like that. Looks fine. Choose Done. It reloads that new texture pack, including our new sound. Choose Done. Back to game. And now we should be fine. Let's go ahead and walk over and see how this does. See if I can reach the cow from here. And there it is. There's our new sound on that cow. Much more exciting than the sound that comes with Minecraft. And that's really all there is to it. It's really simply a matter of making your new sounds as OGG files and then placing those sounds into your resource pack. Now, if you want to go back to the original sounds, let's just back out of here, back to options, back to resource packs, and then load back in the default resource pack right there and choose done. And this will take you back to the original default sounds. So you can go back and forth fairly easily. Back to game notes, our colors have all changed now. It looks normal. And there's that standard sound for the cow. Okay, I'll put that back the way I like it. Back to options, resource packs. Put my sound twos back on top. Choose done. That also puts back in my Mars textures as well. Back to game, and there we go. There's my nice Mars coloration, my nice Mars tree, and our cow. Once you've gone through this process a couple of times, it's really pretty easy to do, pretty straightforward. Then it's simply a matter of deciding on what sounds you want to use and finding your sounds and converting those sounds over to that OGG file format.